of the day on Lumen Christi TV. Today, the church celebrates Saint Apollinaris. Apollinaris was one of the most illustrious bishops of the second century. According to tradition, Saint Peter sent Apollinaris to Ravenna in Italy as its first bishop. His preaching of the good news was so successful that the pagans there beat him and drove him from the city. He returned, however, and was exiled a second time. After preaching in the area surrounding Ravenna, he entered the city again. And after being cruelly tortured, he was put on a ship heading to Greece. Pagans there caused him to be expelled to Italy, where he went to Ravenna for a fourth time. He eventually died from wounds received during a savage beating at Classes, a suburb of Ravenna. A beautiful basilica honoring him was built there in the 6th century. Apollinaris in his lifetime was able to address an apology, that is, a defense of the Christian religion to the emperor Marcus Aurelius, who shortly before had obtained a signal victory over the Cadi. The Cadis were people inhabiting the country. One of his legions was composed chiefly of Christians, and when the army was perishing for want of water, we're told that the soldiers of this legion fell upon the Aeneas and invoked the assistance of God. The result was sudden, for a copious rainfall, aided by the storm, and eventually they conquered the Germans. The emperor named this legion the Thundering Legion. It was to protect his flock against persecution that Saint Apollinaris, who was bishop of Hierapolis in Phrygia, addressed his apology to the emperor in order to implore his protection and to remind him of the favor he had received from God through the prayers of the Christians. Apollinaris later died about the year 175. We take a break as we listen to this song. Jesus involves risks, sometimes the supreme risk of life itself. Martyrs are people who would rather accept the risk of death than deny the cornerstone of their whole life, which is their faith in Jesus Christ. Everyone will die eventually, the persecutors as well as those persecuted. The question is, what kind of a conscience people will bring before the Lord for judgment? Remembering the witness of the past and present matters can help us in our time to make little sacrifices that following Jesus might require from us. Let us pray. God, you made Saint Apollinaris an outstanding example of divine love and the faith that conquers the world, and added him to the role of saintly pastors. Grant by his intercession that we may persevere in faith and love and become sharers of his glory. Amen. Thanks for staying with us. It's been Saints of the Day on Lumen Christi TV. Happy feast day to you.